With OneDrive, we've set out to bring you a robust and scalable service to securely store, share, view, and access your content in Office 365 from anywhere and on any device. Today, I'll walk you through important new enhancements, including the simplified experience for sharing files and folders in OneDrive, new options to monitor and control who has access to your content, and for admins, controls to keep your data safe while keeping your users productive. Keep watching too as I demonstrate the OneDrive experience in Windows 10 with the new OneDrive Files on Demand capability that allows you to see all your cloud files without needing to download them. Over the past few months, we've improved the OneDrive experience across the board, from a unified sync experience for users to a dedicated OneDrive admin center for administrators. The next thing we're delivering is a new sharing experience that makes it easier to share, receive, and protect content. I'll start with Share from Explorer. Here, I'll right-click on a file and choose Share. We're bringing the full set of OneDrive sharing capabilities right here to File Explorer, where millions of people manage their files every day. To share this file, all I need to do is type my recipient's name and click Send. It's that easy. Alex will get this link in email, and I can go back to whatever I was doing. We've improved the experience of getting links too. Let's say I want to copy a link to the clipboard instead. I can right-click and go to Share and hit Copy Link. So it's easy to grab a link when you need one without having to open the document and without having to go to the web. Another area we've focused on is in giving you the ability to customize sharing options. Before I share, I can use link settings to configure who can see this link and what they can do with it. Up top, I've got three choices for who can use this link. I can get a shareable link that works for anyone who has it. It's the easiest way to share when you're okay with people sharing the link with others, including people outside your organization. Anyone with the link can open it without having to worry about accounts or permissions. I can also get a secure link that only works for people inside my organization. It's a great way to share at work while still keeping your organization's content safe. Only people with the link can access this file. They can forward it to others, but this link won't work for anyone outside of my organization. Finally, for the most sensitive content, I can configure the link to only work for the people or groups I specify. This means the link won't work if it's forwarded to anyone other than these people. I can also decide whether people with the link can edit the doc or not. And I can set the expiration date on anyone links to make sure the link stops working after a project has ended. By the way, any policy put in place by my admin would be reflected here, scoping what I can do as a user. In this case, I only want Deborah to have access, so I'll give permission to only her. I apply these settings, and now I'm ready to either send the link or copy it to the clipboard, just like before. All of the features I just showed are available for both files and folders, and they work for both OneDrive and SharePoint. For Mac users, we're bringing this exact same experience right into Finder. Here, I open the context menu and hit Share. I get the same great experience with all the same features. Because this UI is cloud-powered, it's always up to date and in sync with the latest capabilities in the OneDrive service. We're also bringing the same experience to Office desktop apps, including Word, Excel, and PowerPoint for PCs. Here I am on the OneDrive website. I can select a file, choose Share, and you'll see the same great experience with all the same features. This cloud-powered experience will be rolling out in the June-July timeframe for File Explorer and Office apps on Windows, Finder on Mac, OneDrive and SharePoint on the web, and Office Online. Now, with the ease we're bringing to sharing, we're also giving you increased ability to monitor and track who has access to your content. Here, I can go to Manage Access. I can also see what sharing links have been created, as well as who has access through those sharing links. And when I delete a link, it automatically revokes access from anyone who has it. And one more thing. When your content is shared with external users, you'll get an email notification that both lets you know and gives you the opportunity to revoke access on the spot. Now, beyond what you can do as a user, as an admin, you're in control over how your users can share. Here, I can choose what kind of a link is shown by default in the sharing experience. For example, I can choose an internal-only link to avoid accidental oversharing while still allowing users to share externally when it's an intentional action. Remember those email notifications I showed you earlier? Down below, I can enable or disable them for the scenarios I choose. We've also added the ability to prevent external users from resharing your content. If I check this box, external users won't be able to share anything but their own files. In some cases, you may want to limit external sharing to only a subset of your users. First, I'll disable anonymous links, so users can't create links that can be forwarded externally. OneDrive and SharePoint let you specify exactly who's allowed to share externally and will let other users know when policy is stopping them. Here, I can choose the set of users that are allowed to share externally, and OneDrive will make sure that only they are allowed to share outside of my organization. Last year, we showed you how you can limit external sharing by domain with an allow-deny list. Now you have even more granular control with individual allow-deny settings for each and every site collection in your organization. Here, I've selected a site collection, and I'm going to go into sharing settings. I can simply choose to limit external sharing by domain and enter the domains I want to block right here. So we've seen how we're evolving the sharing experience for OneDrive and SharePoint. Now let's take a deeper look at viewing and managing your files in Windows 10 with OneDrive. At Build, we announced the new OneDrive Files on Demand capability, which will allow you to see all of your OneDrive and SharePoint files in File Explorer without overloading your storage. I can see my personal OneDrive files, my OneDrive for Business files, and all the team sites I work with, all in File Explorer. Take a look at this team site. I'm going to go to Properties and take a look at the size. We've got over 120 gigabytes of files in the cloud, and it takes up zero space on my local disk. OneDrive automatically downloads only the content I use. I don't have to change the way I work. Files just appear in File Explorer and work with all my apps. When I open this Word doc, for example, OneDrive downloads it on demand. Whether you have older Win32 apps or the latest Store app, accessing all your files just works, even from the command line. We want to bring the power of the cloud into File Explorer, so we've enabled you to see all the important information around your files right here. A checkmark means it's local, and a cloud means it will download on demand when you use it. If I want to make a file available for later, I can choose Always Keep on this device. For rich media content like photos and videos, OneDrive pulls thumbnails down from the surface and displays them right in Explorer. I'll select this thumbnail and go to Properties just to prove to you that it's not taking up any space on disk. As you heard at Build, this will be coming this summer to Windows Insiders. That was a quick overview of some of the features that are rolling out soon and that we're working on for later this year. Please try out the new sharing experience in OneDrive and SharePoint, and look for OneDrive Files on Demand in Windows 10 Insider builds coming soon. Remember to keep giving us your feedback at User Voice. To learn more, follow the link below. Thanks for watching.